How would you like to discover the 128 gigabyte memory card that you just bought, the SD card, is only worth less than 10 gigabytes of actual storage space? This is Doug Gabbard practicing photography, and I've been in tech for over 20 years, traveled all over the United States and the world, and I've seen quite a bit in technology. So today we're going to talk about SD cards, the memory cards that we use in our cameras. And we're going to talk about how to spot fake SD cards. If you've stumbled across a deal that's too good to be true, it probably is too good to be true. So we're going to uncover a couple of fake cards. I went on a limb and I went out and bought three SD cards in hopes to get at least one fake card, and I succeeded. My first try, ordered three, ordered a 128 gigabyte card, a 64 gigabyte card, and a 16 gigabyte card. The one that failed is this one right here, which is a 128 gigabyte card. Now, the other two, while they didn't fail the test that I'm going to show you, they do not perform well. So I would never put these in any of my computers or any of my camera gear or any of my drones or anything like that. I tested this card on an extra computer. So if there was any malware on it or anything that was malicious, it's on this computer that's really not connected to the internet, and I am not going to be worried about it if it did anything bad. And so what does it matter? Well, hopefully you just heard from my previous little comment that it could have bad things on it. That should be enough to keep you away from these cards. But let's say you decide to purchase one anyway and you'll format it so you'll get rid of the virus, and you know, maybe it will, maybe it won't, but you think it will, and you put it in your camera. It may not write as fast as you expect it to. So if you have a camera that has burst ability where it can take 5, 10, 20 photos per second, you're probably not going to do that for very long before it buffers up and won't be able to take any more photos until it finishes writing. So to give you an idea, I only paid like $4 or $5 for all three of these cards, not each. I think one of them was right around a dollar. It may even been less than a dollar. I can't remember. The 128 gig, I think it was only $2 and something. All total, counting shipping, it was under $10 to get all three cards. So I'll put a link down below for a good SD card. It's a 64 gig. It's on Amazon. It's 200 megabytes per second, and it has a great write speed. Check it out. Appreciate it if you use my affiliate link. So let me show you the software that I use to test an SD card. And do this even with a brand new card you buy from Best Buy or Amazon. So I'll put myself down in the corner and you'll see what a bad SD card looks like on ValiDrive. So first, here's the website, grc.com, called ValiDrive. So once you've downloaded the software, install it and run it, this is what it looks like on a good card. This was the 64 gig card and it was good. So we'll hit check drive and you can see that if you got your USB already plugged in, they tell you to take it out, wait a few moments, 10 seconds probably. Plug in your drive. When you plug it in, it's going to detect it. Once it detects it, you can hit validate this drive. And the red boxes are bad areas. The green boxes are the good areas. So you can see my 128 gig card did not turn out too good. And if you want to look at the report, this is what the report looks like. You can see report number 4. It's 134 gigabytes or 128 gig. And only has good 17.3 gigabytes of space on it. Not too hot. Now that you've seen firsthand how these fake cards can deceive us, let's talk about how you can protect yourself. There are some key strategies that you can use to ensure you're buying genuine, reliable SD cards that won't let you down when you need them the most. So before you get that credit card out to purchase your next SD card, review these tips that I'm going to provide you to help you avoid purchasing an invalid or fake SD card so that you'll be buying genuine cards to protect your memories. So here are 5 tips to help you protect yourselves from getting fake cards. Number 1, always buy from a reputable dealer. You know, Amazon's pretty good, but you might have a fake one sneak in there. Best Buy, you're probably pretty safe. Your local tech company, probably pretty safe. Number 2, look for reviews. If the website has reviews, but be careful. Website reviews can be fake too. Number 3, check the price. If it is dirt cheap, like the cards I purchased were under $10 for all three cards. And that included the shipping. Verify the packaging. The packaging that mine came on had Chinese writings on it, so they were shipped from overseas. That's the location most of the fake cards come from. Number 5, verify with a tool like ValiDrive that I provided you. Like I said, I'll put a link down below for ValiDrive on sgrc.com. There's also a link for my affiliate link to Amazon for a 64 gig card that is legit. And finally, don't let a good deal ruin your day on a photography chip when your memory card doesn't work because it's a fraud, it's a fake, it doesn't work, it's not fast enough. This is Doug Gabbard, Practicing Photography. Hit the like and subscribe, and I'll see you next week.